We're gonna make a backlit sign that says Club Broussard and Berry. I'm gonna stain this the same color I did my table at. I'm gonna router the edges, round the corners. I'm gonna use these LED lights to go inside here. When the letters are on, it's gonna bounce off the sign base. I've got to mount my bolts for mounting going through my sign base, and I've got to weather the front of the signs. The Z is what it looked like originally. This B has already been weathered just slightly. I have to get my LED strip lights, and I've got to run bracket right here, hide the wires for the lights to go inside the LED light, inside the letters. The first thing that we've got to do is clean the surface area on the back of the signs, flux it, solder our fasteners, our bolts, to the back of the letter. It's the first thing we're going to do. Got the soldering iron hooked up, everything's good to go. We're going to start working on this particular B. And we're going to start cleaning a small area for the flux. But you got your area all cleaned up. I clean the surfaces with a little bit of alcohol on a rag. Just make them nice and clean. Well, that's ready for some solder. Next thing I'm gonna do before I solder that, I'm gonna clean the back of the bolts, the fasteners. I'll do my other fastener and I'll clean it with alcohol, and then we're ready to put it, attach it to our letter. I'm gonna get my soldering iron. I'm just gonna touch the metal, kind of warm it up a little bit. I'm gonna get my flux and just dip my bolt in the back of it. I'm gonna put that on my clean part by just clean. I'm gonna set this sideways so it doesn't, I don't lose my flux. And I'm gonna get my soldering iron. I'm gonna melt my solder onto this. And I'll keep my solder, my iron, I'll keep my soldering iron into the solidified solder so it heats up the sign and stick. I'll make a nice big bulb there. That should be about right. So the head of that bolt will stick in there. I'll do the same thing with this other side. I've got my solder on the back of my letter. I'm gonna use a blowtorch to fasten my bolt. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna heat up the back of my fastener. Make sure it's nice and hot. Then I'm gonna put it in the solder and kind of move it back and forth to my head of my bolt so it stays hot. Make sure that solder's nice and, there we go. And I'm just gonna try to hold it as straight as I possibly can while the solder hardens. With that flux and that solder, it's a strong enough connection to hold this little letter anyway. There we go. Now, that's it. I'll do this other one. Now I've got both fasteners on there, nice and strong. It'll hold up this little letter without any problem. The issue that you have, and this one wasn't so bad, the reason why I've got to age it is you can see where the fastener is attached. Now this one isn't too bad. It'll become brown, so I have to sand this completely down with the wire brush, and I'm going to age the front of it so you can't tell where I attached the bolts on the back side of it. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to sand this down right now. So I'm going to get my drill and start taking off this these marks on here. Now I finished with the wire brush on the drill on the front of this B, and this is what the original one looks like. I took all those and I all those marks off there. The primary thing was where the bolts attach. So in order to make it consistent, not just one little area, I had to do the whole thing. Now I'm going to do that little bit of aging process. The way we're going to age this is with white vinegar and some hydrogen peroxide. Here's one that's been done. Here's a bead that's been done, and this is the one that I'm doing now. I'll get my white vinegar. Pour just a little bit into a cup. Hydrogen peroxide. Get some in a little cup. I get my vinegar first and spread it on with a Q-tip until I completely cover the letter. I'll spread it all around. I'm not gonna let it dry. Putting it on, I'm kind of thick. I don't want it to dry just yet. If you notice, when I did the wire brush to the letter, I kept the bristles the same way, so it would look all even. Now I'm gonna let this sit for a few minutes, and then I'm gonna hit it with a torch. It's been about 2 or 3 minutes. I'm gonna fire my torch up. I'm gonna slowly just kind of go over the whole thing, kind of quick, just so the metal kind of sort of get hot relatively at the same time. And then I'll start focusing in one area and start really getting that, really getting the vinegar in there. Just go all the way around. And burn that vinegar in there. Don't put too much heat on it, because you'll melt the solder on the other side and your bolts will fall off. Now this bead has been done with the vinegar, and I'm going to do it now with the hydrogen peroxide. I let it cool for a few minutes, and it seems to work better. I don't know why, if the material is just a little bit warm. So I'm just going to warm it back up, and I'm going to put my hydrogen peroxide on it right now. So this is my hydrogen peroxide cup. Going to keep doing this. And those are my dogs in the background. I'm going to coat the whole surface with this hydrogen peroxide. Now, go back to my torch. And same process. Kind of go over the whole thing, kind of warm it up, and then I'm gonna get it. You can see it changing colors. I may have to do it one more time on this letter. It looks like I'll have to do it twice on this one. It'll look very consistent. Not the vinegar twice, just the hydrogen peroxide. That's what it looks like now. But there's some spaces, there's spots in there I don't like. So I'm going to do one more. I'm going to let it cool a minute. And then do one more coat of hydrogen peroxide over the whole thing. And then burn it again. And that should go away. If not, then I'll just live with it like that. It'll be fine. I'm going to try it one time. Okay, that's another hydrogen peroxide. Second hydrogen peroxide. I'm just going to get a paper towel. Kind of wipe off. There's a little white dusty stuff that comes off there. I don't know what it is, but wipe it off. And then there's your letter. And then this one is ready to be put to the side and to be mounted. Now I've got to do all the rest of my letters the same way that I just did this B right here. And what I'll do is, I got a workflow going on, is I'll do 4, 6, maybe 8, clean the back of the heads. Hello. And then I'll do, you know, however many faster bolts that I do, I'll do the same thing, clean these and then tin these. And then I will solder the fasteners on there, and then I'll burn it and I'll do all that stuff, or, you know, sand it. So it's better than doing one at a time. Just do a whole bunch of them at the same time. Well, hello. So that's how we're gonna do the rest of this sign. Yes. I finally got all my bolts on there, my fasteners. I've measured, spaced the letters out where I want them. I'm doing the club right now, and I'm using this 2x4 and this other piece of wood for my spacers, and I'm just simply spacing them out how with the spacer there, the piece of wood, and taping my letters down so they'll stay up by themselves. And what this will do is this will allow me to mark my bolt holes when it's down on the piece of wood. I can see it and I can just mark them, take them off, drill them. And that's what I gotta do to all my letters right now. It'll take a while, but that's the step that I'm on now. I've gone through and marked every single hole where these things stand up with a pencil, line them all up, and I'm just gonna drill them. And then gotta paint the letters. After drilling, paint the letters, let that dry while it's drying. We're gonna route the edges of this thing and we're gonna stain. That's what we're gonna do now. Some clear, and I'm just gonna go over this with clear and let it dry and do all my letters that way. And kind of give some kind of protection from the elements. Now we're cutting our spacers for it to keep our letters up off the board, off the sign. Start with this material here. I cut it down to this. I put a notch in it. I sand it and I just paint it flat black and that's it. So how this is gonna work is this wire is gonna come up from underneath here, okay? You have a spacer. That's what that notch is for. The wire's gonna come up from the bottom. And that spacer keeps this off the board. That'll be coming through the board. And you have another spacer. You only need to cut a notch in one of them. So what it's gonna look like is that. And I'm just gonna square these up. Fast tighten it down from the other side, and then that's you're done. And this will be coming through, and this is where you get your electricity. And when on the other side, I'll connect all my circuits together, and all the lights will work at the same time, link same time, fade at the same time, whatever I want. These fasteners right here, they actually say the sign is on this. So the sign is here. So there's no force on the sign. It's not even load bearing. So when I tighten this from the other side, it'll stay secured and it doesn't give any force on my little weld there, if you want to call it a weld, and it should be fine just like that. So that's the next step I got to do. Cut a million of these, paint a million of these, and we'll be set for all of them. I have all my holes drilled. I've got all my spacers cut with the one with the notches I need, all my spacers cut without the notches. I still haven't decided if I'm gonna paint these or not. We'll see. The logistics officer might like it that way, so we'll keep it that way. All these are ready to go with the spacers. Now I've got to go and I've got to notch out the backside of this for my wire, because the wire's got to come through the back, through the spacer, into the letter, so LED lights will be lit up. I'm going to hide those. So that's going to be a hard part. I got to notch every single one of these on the back side around the washer, and that's what we're going to do now. I've got all my holes drilled in the back, and I had to come in with the Dremel and slightly widen the hole. I had to drill in, turn the drill sideways, and I get my Dremel tool. I made enough room for my wire to come through. So I get my Dremel, I widen this hole, and I can stick the wire through. That wire goes through, goes to that back bracket, and the LED is gonna be behind the letter, and the letter's gonna look like that on the front. I've gotta do the rest of these. So all of them should be perfect. I forgot that I was going to round the corner, so I ahead and broke out the jigsaw and rounded the corners, and now I'm gonna go ahead and sand all my marks off of it, make it smooth, do my edges with a router, and stain both sides, clear the front, stain the back so it'll be protected from the weather somewhat. So now I'm going to sand the top of this thing, get all these marks off of it. It's gonna take forever because I don't have an electric sander, so. Everything's gonna be by hand. I'm standing in the back of this right now. So I'm just doing this to protect it from, you know, some of the weather when it sits outside, so it'll last longer. And this is matching, this is gonna match the table that I've already done out front, or in the back patio. I'm gonna let this dry, and then I'm gonna flip it over, route it, and then stain the front side of it, let it dry, and then I'm gonna put the epoxy on the front.
We're gonna route the sign. Miss Jen's gonna help me out, logistics officer, again. Mm-hmm. We're gonna do this at night. Hopefully we don't piss off the neighbors. And we're gonna do this right now.
I've sanded the backside of it. All the holes are drilled, top is sanded, routed, everything's done. Now I'm going to burn the edges of it with this torch, very slightly. With this torch, I'm just going to barely touch it and just kind of give it a little bit of coloration coming in from the sides, nice and easy. And I'm going to just brown it just a little bit coming up from the edges, and I'm going to make it dark on the side, a lighter in the middle, and just barely just come up with it. And I'm gonna do that around the whole sign. And that's gonna match the little plaques we have on the other table. And then of course I'm gonna stain it after this process. Let the stain dry overnight, and then tomorrow I'll put the epoxy on there. This is gonna look really cool. Okay, burn all around the edges. Hopefully it's consistently and consistent. So now I'm going to stain the top, and gonna blend this in to match the back table. And I'm gonna do this whole thing, let it dry, and probably do one more coat, because I think the back one I did twice. So we kind of want it to, the idea is to match the back table that I did. So anyway, we're gonna do this whole thing just like this. Now we're ready to glaze or epoxy the front of the sign. And I've got two of these super glazed epoxies, and it says in the instructions that the best temperature is above 70 degrees. Well, it's 57 degrees outside and 66 degrees inside. So it also says in the instructions you can put hot water in a sink and bring up the temperature of the glaze or the epoxy, and that's what I've done. I've got, I had to buy two of them. I'm covering 12 square feet. One of these bottles, well, you have to mix them, cover 6 square feet or 6.5. So this is perfect for 12 square feet. It's in water right now, and I've taken off. There's a seal that's on there. I previously took that off, so I don't have to mess with it later. So they're still in here, they're soaking. And then I'm gonna go outside, pour it in the bucket, stir it up for 6 to 8 minutes, probably. I'm gonna do it for 8 minutes, and then pour it onto my sign and spread it out. So these have to sit here for a few more minutes, and then I'm ready to go. One thing you wanna do before you pour your epoxy is make sure that your surface is level, because it's self-leveling stuff. When I did my table, I didn't do this, and it was starting to run off on one side, and I had to do it while it was drying. It was a big pain. So I leveled it first this time. I'll mix my resin. We'll go pour this stuff on here. Now in the instructions, it says that you're supposed to pour it and measure a certain amount in a different container, a certain amount in a different container. Make sure the same equal 1-to-1 ratio, pour it, then mix it. Well, I'm not doing it that way. And what we're going to do is we're going to time this. Boom. We're going to stir it for 8 minutes. Here we go. And the instruction says, do not use a mechanical, electrical drill or anything on it. Just start by hand. Okay, it's been 8 minutes. Been stirring this. Looks good. I've got my spreader ready to go. And Hopefully I'll do a better job on this table than I did on the last one. So you spread, pour it on all over. And then you use your knife to spread it out. And hopefully I've done it right. Just nice and easy. It's supposed to go in one direction. So I'll go in one direction. Not really sure why, but that's what you're supposed to do. I see why they have a temperature range for usage. Pretty chilly in the garage, but once you do that, you gotta get your torch. And you gotta get rid of the air bubbles. So anywhere there's air bubbles, you just gotta run your torch and just get rid of them real quick. All those little air bubbles, you gotta go through and just briefly run your torch on it real quick. And this will make this sign look really good. Nice and shiny. No air bubbles will be in it. It's been about 30 minutes, and that is the perfect time to come and scrape all these little driplets off, these little drops. So later you don't have to come and sand them down. On the other table, I had to sand them down. I waited till they dried. And on this one, I'm not gonna wait. It's still drying. About 30 minutes. And you can already see the where it's burnt, the different color in the wood. Where I put the torch on it. So it's gonna look really good. Now it's finally time to put the lights in the back of the letter. And again, we're using the Supernights. There's the LED lights. Remote and controllers in there. And your power supply. So we're gonna go ahead and open this up, and we're gonna start to wire this thing. LED lights. Right here. First thing you of course want to do is test them, make sure they work. Controller and remote are going to be in here. And I'm thinking that one roll of lights will do all these letters. I'm hoping. I don't know. And pull a little tab out. Boom. Here we go. Now I just gotta hook it up to test to see if it works. Okay. Remote, there's the remote sensor. Down, up, change colors. All that seems to be working. Fade, works. Jump, that works. Flash, that works. So it looks like everything works on this thing. So we're gonna go ahead and start wiring this right now. This is the top of the letter, this is the bottom of the letter. All the letters have this flat spot on the bottom. Here is my spacer. It goes in the bottom of the letter, how I'm gonna do it. And then this is going to run through there just like that into the piece of wood. Now I may not have enough of this, I don't know, enough wire coming out the back of the board. I may have to manually make these things. So what we're going to do, the idea was to run it up like that. That's the idea right there. And then your light goes in there. So I'm going to measure my light. How much I need. And all I'm gonna do is we will run it Let's see how we're gonna do this. We'll start here, and all I'm gonna do is just, where's the first LED light? There we go. That's how we're gonna do it, just like that. And all I'm gonna do is follow it around. Doesn't have to be perfect, I don't think. As long as it stays in there. And then last LED light will be here. So I will cut it. Actually, for safety, I'm going to cut it right here. Right there, I'm going to cut it. So as safety, so I can attach my next strip, I always cut it at, not way up here, but I always cut it down at the very bottom of the copper, because I have to use this part to attach my next strip of lights. The next strip of lights, which comes from here, doesn't have this connection on it already. Now, I figured on how to do this. It took me a while to figure this out. This actually is made for the lights that aren't waterproof. These are waterproof. It's got that little thin coating on it. So you have to strip this down, this rubber off, and slide it underneath that clip. And that's what I'm going to do now, is cut that down. So what you have to do is you have to cut straight down. I figured out how to do this. Get a little harder surface. You got to cut straight down with the razor blade. Through the clear. And I just bend it back a little bit. I may have cut too far. No, I didn't cut far enough. There it goes. And then I just peel that off. Now I got the rubber piece off, and this is exposed. And all I do is, for extra added protection or connection, I just scrape this a little bit with the razor. If there's any extra glue on there from the rubber coating. And this is the way this works. It took me forever to get this right, to make it work. All you do is you get this and you slide it underneath those little clip deals and just push it. You can't solder on these little bitty things here because they come off. I tried a million times, it didn't work. So you got to get these little connector things. And you slide it, and then that's how it makes the connection. And then you clamp it down. Now, I was even going to the extent of putting a little zip tie around that to hold it closed, but it seems to work fine doing it this way. And now all I do is test it to make sure it still works. Now the way I'm going to test this, I'm going to get the original light strip, the piece that I cut off. There's a little arrow on here, and there's a little arrow on here. You match the arrows up and you plug them into each other with this little dude here. So I just simply look at the wires, blue, red, green, and black. This one's white. It'll be the same thing. So all I'm going to do is, just real quick, just touch these, and there we go. See, they come on. And then I can change colors. So they're working. So the connection's good. After messing with these, putting them on the RV, putting them back around the house, I always check my connections because you never know. So now I'm going to get my letter. Now I'm going to try to stick this on the inside. This side is already clamped in there, so I'm going to try to peel it from this other side and try to use the sticky. It never works on anything. It sticks on anything. I don't understand. But there it goes. Okay. All right, now, trying to do this exactly like I laid it out without touching the sticky on anything, but what I want it to, which is the letter, just gonna kind of route this. I want to go to the middle of the letter. See, I'm already sticking all the towel and everything else. And I want to go something like this. It might stay in there, I don't know. Hopefully I don't have to glue it, because that glue is a pain. It takes a day to dry. It's really a challenging issue. I'm gonna try to keep it kind of sort of to the center of the letter if I can. Of course, this is the first letter I've done, so I don't have a workflow yet. There we go. There we go. And it did not come out. It's not long enough. See that? It's not long enough. So what I'll do is I'll put this strip into a different letter and I'll cut another one for this one. Okay, we're almost done with the sign. About all these letters, when I put the resin in, it filled in these holes a little bit, so I had to drill them out again so they would fit. Everything seems to be working just perfect the way that I planned it. Got my spacers, lights are already in, everything's done. All I'm doing is placing the letters onto the sign and feeding my wire through the bottom hole of each letter the way that I planned it out. It seems like it's working pretty good. And fits on just like that. And I go to the other side and I bolt it down, screw it down. This is the back side of the sign, and the bottom of each hole is my lead wires coming out. All I did from the bolt hole, I drilled in, and then I got my drill and drilled to the side, so I'll have a space for my wires to come out on each one of the leads that I need. This is my B going in now for my berry. And let's hand tighten them down. My little lead coming off to the side. Seemed like it's working perfect. There's my lead so I can connect my wires. Back to the front side of the sign, I just line up my spacers and I'll tighten them down so they're square. Get my wrench, my ratchet, just barely hand tighten it on there. That's all I need. Seems like that's good enough just to secure it. And that's the B mounted for Barry. And I've almost got the whole sign completely done. It's got to do the E-E-R-Y. Well, I got one light working just for an experiment because I wanted to see how it looks with all the letters on there. But only one light's just temporarily hooked up. By no means it's permanent right now. But I've got the fade effect. I can change my colors on it. I've almost completed wiring the entire sign. I've got, 21 letters, and each connection, each letter has four wires to it, so that's a lot of connections. So this whole thing is almost done. I've got my controller coming in here, power supply, and it just runs along in a series all the way down to the back of each one of these letters is powered. I'll do this last connection. I've already obviously done all the rest of them. Do this last connection. What I try to do is line my wires up, my colored wires with the next wire, so they'll just fit in. I'm doing wire ties to make my connections. I was going to use a connection like this, and I'd have to solder everything together on every single one of these connections. It would take forever. And on not only that, maintenance, I'd have to either unsolder it or cut it to pull my letter out to repair something. This way, I can just unscrew the wire ties, unbolt it, drop the letter out, and that's all I've got to do. I can fix that one, put it back in without messing around with solder and all that other kind of crazy stuff. So I'll go through each one of these, because they've been tinned, and they won't fray apart very much. And just get them down where I can work with them. Now the wire that's coming in, I'll only do one at a time on each side. I found that if you don't, they fray all over the place because obviously these haven't been tinned and they won't stay together. And I'll do the same thing with all these wires. Once you get a workflow down, it's not that bad. I had to figure it out how to make this as efficient as possible. Of course, doing it more, I get better at it. After doing all these letters, these connections. And I found you get a little pair of pliers, twist them together really good. Be very careful without tearing the wire up. This one needs to be stripped a little bit more. A little shy on that one. Go. And this way I can fix the ones when they go out. It'll be easier to fix it. And I just get my wire nut. And then that's the connection. I have to do that for the last one over here. And once this is done, I'll test it. Okay, we're getting closer to the finishing point. All the lights are done, everything's wired. Now we're hooking up the system to hang it. There's gonna be a chain with hooks. So I've cut these little pieces of wood. I measured them where they go. Still isn't completely dry, that's why it's that color. I've got some screws. They're exactly the right length. They're 1 1/4 inch, so I can screw this all the way down without going through the other side of the piece of wood, the sign. Put my hooks in, I'm gonna drill a pilot hole for the hook, screw that down, measure how far that needs to go in, and I can hook my chain to this and on the other side, and we have a system to hang it from. I didn't have to do pilots on this one for the other side. I secure it with 4 screws and then the hook in the middle. Now what I decided to do, decided to dress it up a little bit. I got these small pieces of wood. I cut it to the length that I wanted it. I rounded the edge, just slightly sanded this side of it here so it's a little bit smooth. I stained it and it's still wet. And I mounted it on here because when you look at it from the side, you'll be able to see these wires and whatnot. And I'm gonna fasten these down here in a little bit, so a little bit more squared away. But so now you won't be able to see all this, these wires and all this crazy stuff that's going to be back here. You won't be able to see it through this side. Now I've got to mount the other one on there now. Also what I did is there's a nut that comes through right there and that holds the sign on, one of the sign letters on. So I routed that so that thing could just lay smooth right there. Here's my other piece. It's still a little bit wet. Again, it's routed here for this bolt, and this is routed all the way through so my remote control sensor can be seen through with the remote. What I did is I just got a black marker and just kind of marked it up, camouflaged it a little bit, and then when I need to replace that, if it ever goes bad, I can just pull that all the way through this hole, replace it, and stick the new one back in there, and I don't have to remove anything. Now I'm just holding this little kind of a dress up piece by these little L brackets and these little short little screws, and it's a non-load bearing kind of situation, and it's all you need. So now from the side you won't be able to see all this stuff back here when it's hanging up. Now we have to extend our power source to go from the plug to the sign. This wire I'm using is just outdoor wire for outdoor lighting, low volt outdoor 12 volt stuff. Safe using this application. So that's what I'm going to do now. Now I'm going to tin my wire And I'm going to attach my wires. This is the side that goes to the controller from the power supplies. I put my heat shrink on this one, on each individual one. I'll put my larger heat shrink around all of that. Now, I'm going to attach my two wires for my power. Get some heat going. Okay, there's that one connection. And that's secure, that's fine. Nothing go wrong with that bad boy there. And then now, we got to do the other one, the other side. I finished my power source. The extension's on there, everything's plugged in, tested, it works. Now, we've got to go hang it up and test it. Our Club Broussardenberry sign is completely done. This is what it looks like in the daytime. It's got the nice epoxy finish on it, and it matches the table perfectly. This is the table that Jen and I did. Epoxied it, put our patches underneath it, made the plaques that go underneath it. And of course, it's underlit with light. The tabletop and the Club Broussardenberry sign match perfectly.
Wednesday, January 20th, 2016, and we just wanted to announce that Club Broussardenberry is now open for business.